I like to subscribe, do all that. You already know what time it is. It's Netflix time. This movie is called The Last Letter from Your Lover. After finding a trove of love letters from 1965, a reporter sets out to solve the mystery of the secret affair while embarking on a romance of her own. So it's one of those real life dramas that just came out. It's about an hour and 50 minutes long.
Spoiler alert, let's get it.
So we start off with this couple. Harry just picked up Ginny from the hospital. And right now the setting is London, 1965. Now the reason she's coming from the hospital is because something happened to her. She had temporary amnesia. Larry ends up pulling his letter out of his pocket, officially stamped to Ginny.
What does it all mean?
Ginny's back in the mirror and she sees a scar on her face. And we're thinking to herself, what kind of an accident was she in? She gets all dolled up for her husband. And after that, they go to bed. Next thing you know, it's the year 2019. We have this girl named Ellie, who just gave some random guy a business. That one night stand life. It turns out she gotta get ready for work. So she heads up to a job. We find out that she's a journalist. She's looking at pictures of her ex-boyfriend. So here's Nick. This is the guy to his right, to her right. Ellie takes on the task that he was assigned to. To do this, they go to the other side of the building. She meets this guy named Rory. He pretty much runs the human development department and all this other stuff. He tells her she's got to set up an appointment to go through all the archives there. And then she'll come back. Then we go back to 1965 with Ginny. And she's got a friend that's trying to help her recap all the events that occurred. Because she basically can't remember anything. Don't really know the time frame of how far back she can't remember. Then her, Larry, and all her friends gather around for a dinner. But she can barely get in the word edgewise. So you can tell their relationship was kind of rocky right from the start. Back to present day with Ellie and Rory. And this time she gets an appointment. So they go through the office and she finds one of these letters. One of these intimate letters that was back in 1965 that was sent to Ginny. From a guy who signatured his name, Your Boot. Or B for short. Now clearly that's an alias, so we're thinking to ourselves, who was Your Boot? That letter just happened to be one of the same letters she found in a bookcase the next day after arriving home from the hospital. Now she's going through all these books, she's thinking to herself, why are these letters inside the bookcase books? Especially inside of Harry's studies. Who the hell is sending these letters? As she finds another one in her room. Then we go to 6 months earlier before Ginny's memory loss. Her and her husband was taking a trip. They never really said where, but it's definitely a luxurious spot. Now back in real time for Ginny, she's contemplating these letters. Then she ends up walking down this alley with restaurants. She stops in this place called Alberto's. As she walks right on in, the owner approaches her. And she asks about a man named Felipe. And the owner said Felipe passed away. He was in a coma and never woke up. So now we're hit with the question, who the hell is Felipe? Meanwhile, Rory and Ellie are getting closer. They keep finding all these letters. Then we get to a scene where Ginny's just chilling in a relaxing chair. And keep in mind, this is the 6 month period, like before she got, you know, amnesia. And she's introduced to a guy by the name of Anthony O'Hare. Now, Anthony O'Hare is a guy that publishes articles. And he's published quite a few for Larry. So I guess you could say they were friends or real good acquaintances. Later on, everybody has dinner. Larry ends up discarding Ginny again when she's trying to talk. Anthony went along with it too. He kind of made up an ass out of himself, but they knew he was drinking. Later on, while he's talking to this one lady, Ginny comes and interrupts him, and he apologizes for how he acted at the table. So next day, they're about to do some shopping, and after everybody left, they happen to notice that Anthony was still there. He tries to give her an apology letter. She's like, no, you can read it to me. She accepts his apology letter, and she's like, well, I can't have you inebriated driving. You're going to ride with us. And he's supposed to meet up with her and her husband later. So they're at the spot just getting lunch, and here comes Anthony. Now, Larry's always on business, and he gets called away to go to business right afterwards. So that gives Anthony and Ginny time to know each other. She ends up taking him on this boat. They talk about the situations, how he's divorced, but he does have a kid. But the kid is with his ex-wife. And even though she's married, she's still kind of intrigued by him. Now, there are timelines within the story, but I want you to keep in mind, the apology letter is the first letter he ever gave to Ginny. Meanwhile, Ellie is finding all these other letters. They go from apology to intimate to turning to love letters real quick, which both her and Rory take time to discover. Then we get to a scene where Ginny's with her friends at the beach, and she just happens to see Anthony there, just cheesing all his way and all that shit. Now, through all this time, they've been sending love letters back and forth to each other. So you can pretty much figure out Your Boot is Anthony. So there you go. And of course, she goes by Princess Jay in the letters. Now, I know you're thinking to yourselves, how can they be spending all this time together, right? Well, as it turns out, Larry's always on business trips, and this is just one of them where he takes like 4 days. So one particular day, it starts raining, they hop in her car. And of course, it doesn't start right away. So he plays a little game within the car, tells her to close her eyes. And basically for her to imagine places she wants to go and things she wants to see. Then they have a little moment in the car. You can tell this shit's starting to get serious. But then she tries to start the car up again, it works. And she takes her to the hotel that he's staying at. Bet money she gonna remember that hotel. Then it flashes to Ellie reviewing more letters. Every time she finds a letter, it tells us more of the story. Well, anyway, Rory text messaged her, and he said he found a letter that sounded like it was going to be an affair. So the next day, Ginny ends up coming back to the hotel. She gets the room number he's staying in, 302. She came directly to see him. He tells her he's got to shave while she's in the room admiring stuff. Nigga, you ain't got no facial hair. What the hell you got to shave? Then when she leaned in to kiss him, he backed away. He apologized, but then she left. Later on, she gets a letter saying that he didn't want to reject her or anything like that. He wanted to kiss her bad. He just wanted to make sure that she was certain. He tells her to meet her at the park at a certain time. And while he's there waiting, she's there to greet him. And then it happened. Then they end up going to this club called Alberto's. Remember that? And this is where we meet Felipe. He's a friend of Anthony's. So there you go, that's Felipe. She throwing them shots back and then she gets the dance in. Then they head to a back room. And yes, he ends up giving her the business. Meanwhile, in present time, Ellie and Rory are heading to the storage room to see where they can find more letters. So then they get there, and they find a bunch of them. When he helps her down off the ladder, sparks fly. Then they distract each other, talking about, yeah, we should get started on those letters. Now back then, Jenny would go to the certain post office, and she would get all her letters from Anthony sent there. Then she met up with him again, you already knew what time it was, giving more of their business. Then they meet back at a special place, the park. Right when she's about to go back to her husband, Anthony's like, well, I'm about to move to New York soon to work on his publishing company. And he wants Jenny to come with him. Jenny's like, oh, that's a hell of a step. I still got my husband here. I got family and friends. And he's saying to her, don't let them hold you back if you're not happy. Now, anybody would think that's ludicrous at this point, but she knows that he's absolutely right. But how's she going to go about it? Then she gets another emotional letter from Matt Anthony, which made her come to a decision. She's going to leave her husband. That's a tall tale sign right there. She put a wedding ring on the table. Now, why she would just leave it out like that, I had no fucking idea. So while she's got a backpack running to meet Anthony at the train station, Anthony's there waiting on Jenny. But instead of waiting on a taxi, she went to Alberto's to go find Felipe, the driver there. He's still waiting. The train's about to pull off. And as they're driving, a car blindsides them. Oh, shit. Whoever was in the other car was done deal dead. Now, obviously, Jenny lived through that because that's how she came back and she couldn't remember anything. But this is how Felipe died. And we get back to Ellie and Rory again reading letters. And they end up reading the events that occurred. Then Rory gets a call, Ellie picks up the phone, and Rory's ex-girlfriend of all things is calling him like, where are you at? Come to find out all of his friends are hosting a birthday party for him. So she's like, why is your ex-girlfriend making sure you have a birthday party? Well, he's like, well, my ex-girlfriend is still friends with my sister. And they invited themselves, so there you go. So he wants to know a little more about Ellie. So then she tells a story about how she cheated on her ex-boyfriend. She didn't want to get attached to him because he wanted to have kids. She wants to have kids someday, but not with him. And here we are. You're starting to see a pattern here. Jenny was cheating on her husband with Anthony. Ellie was cheating on her boyfriend because she didn't want to have kids. Kind of fall from the same cloth, right? Well, anyway, she gets Rory out there to start dancing. Later on, they go back to his place. And they start their kissing. And yeah, she definitely gave him the business. And then she snuck out while he was sleeping. She ain't about that commitment life. And then she heads over to the post office. It's literally the same post office Jenny used to go to over 50 years ago, right? So she asked the teller if she could have a certain address so she can send letters to. Teller's like, yeah, no, we don't give out the information. There you go. So she's going to do a journalism and find a way to get the information. When she went back to work, she ended up finding another letter. And she ended up getting the info she needed, ironically. So she goes to the house and she actually finds Jenny. But Jenny don't want nothing to do with her. It's a private matter. She don't want her business affairs being put out again. Then we go back to the past when she's at the post office. This is right after the accident. Or more specifically, after she found the letters in the books. She goes to the prompt teller and finds out her mailbox has been closed off. So she goes to the maid of the house and is like, look, I need the keys to my husband's studies. She goes in his desk and finds the letter, the one letter where Anthony wanted her to leave to go to New York. Apparently, she had that letter on her when the accident happened. So that was the letter Larry had in his pocket at the beginning of the movie. She confronts Larry about the letters and how come he locked the mailbox. He's like, I know what's going on. I know who's been sending you letters too. It was Anthony. So to keep her under his thumb, he tells her Anthony died in a car crash. He's like, no, that's bullshit. I was riding with Felipe. But he tells her Anthony was in the other car, the one that hit them. He says apparently he was in such a rush to try to get to you that he ended up running into your car. Now, why would he do that if he's waiting on the train? That sounded like complete and utter bullshit, but she believed him. Nonetheless, she still tried to search to find him. Then in real time, we have Ellie looking up the London Chronicle. And she finds an article done by Anthony O'Hare. She didn't know whether he was alive or not, but she had found an address and started sending him letters. Or emails. Meanwhile, Rory's texting her, trying to figure out what's the deal, and she don't know what to say to him. As she's walking, she's chilling by the bridge, and she starts thinking about Rory. Next day, she actually gets a phone call from Anthony O'Hare. I'm like, what the fuck? And now she gets to talk to him one-on-one and have an interview. She asks him when the last time she's seen Jenny. He said back in 1969. That's right, 4 years have passed by since they've seen each other. He's at a Christmas party, and so is Jenny. Now, clearly, it's like she's seen a ghost. She's been thinking he's been dead the whole time. And as soon as she seen him, she passed out right on the spot. She wakes back up, surprised that he's here. She's like, take me back to your room. So with the amount of time that's passed, he's been in New York for about all four years. He just happened to come back to London for this Christmas party. Within those 4 years, Jenny and Larry ended up having a 2-year-old daughter now. But they definitely missed each other, and they tense us a long way to business. Man, y'all already know. Then he tries to get her to come to New York again, and she's like, man, things are different this time. I would drop everything for you if I didn't have my daughter. And that was the last time he seen her. He hasn't seen her in 50 years. He gives her all the letters that Ellie had. He didn't even realize that Jenny's been looking for him all this time. Then Ellie goes back to Jenny, and Jenny finally listens to her. They have a one-on-one sit down. Ellie tells Jenny everything that Anthony was going through. They don't even know that they're both still in London. Then she tells the story right from the time that she left the hotel. Then she got a heated argument with her husband. She tells him she's only here for their daughter. She found out that Anthony was still alive. And basically tells him if he acts like anything other than a husband, he'll threaten to take his daughter away. He's like, no court's gonna allow that shit. You cheating on your husband and running away with a daughter? Like, come on. Which he definitely had a valid point on. Nonetheless, she tried her hand anyway. First, she went back to the hotel to find Anthony, but then finds out he checked out. Then she goes to his job and finds out he recently resigned because he was going back to New York. So she left a bunch of the love letters in their hands. And that's crazy. All this time, 50 years later, those letters are still there. in that same office. So Ellie's trying to convince them to meet up. She's thinking hopefully it'll get through to Jenny. She turned in her article. Her boss is pleased and all that. And then she calls Rory. She's basically out in the rain apologizing to him about everything. She's sorry she didn't answer the phone. She's sorry she didn't send any text messages back. Because she feels like she's falling in love with him, honestly. She tells him look out the window as she's standing under his flat in the rain. And then he forgives her real quick. Then she talks to him about her plan to get Anthony and Jenny to meet up. She talks to Anthony, and once she finds out that Jenny's been trying to get to him all this time, Anthony writes one more letter. Puts the letter in the main mailbox, same mailbox, tells everything she needed to hear, and tells her to meet her at the park at a certain time. Yep, waiting for it at the same park. And it took her a while, but she showed up. Again, it's been 50 years since they seen each other. That shit is crazy. Then we get a flashback of what was supposed to happen that day on the train. They show her actually getting there, they hug and all that. But once again, they're envisioning what they wanted to happen that day. And that's it.
So yeah, it's a story about true love and everything coming together. It's all happy, dappy, and everything's great.
I mean, you're basically trying to leave your husband for this guy, but still.
The last letter from your lover on Netflix. Check it out. I like Chris. Gotta do all that. You don't know what time it is. Look, these are the easy best. Big, you got this slogan.